Greetings everyone. Good afternoon ladies and gentlemen. I, Chirag Agarwal.
I, Ajitesh Gupta.
We are from River Yamuna. So, before starting for today's presentation, I was searching for audience who can buy such products, such as my puppies, my car. I'm selling this sofa set. So, is there anyone who can buy this? So, any guess? Topic? Yeah, exactly right. So, we are going to discuss on the topic OLX. So, let's watch a video. Please play the video.
मम्मी के घर आने से पहले लिविंग रूम सेट है जो चाहे बेचो जो चाहे खरीदो विद द ऑल न्यू ओएलएक्स ओएलएक्स सेट है
Our main objective of selecting this topic was based on my personal experience in 2017. Actually I sold my car. So based on this personal experience, the unused goods in our house which are not used and which are ignored by some people, which can be sold and which can be used by anyone who can't afford it, the new ones, who can't afford new ones, which can use the products. So managed to be the India's largest free categorized wise, it is successfully launched in India. So moving towards contents.
So starting with the contents, our contents for the today's presentation includes introduction, what is OLX, type of ads and pricing strategy, revenue, growth and profit, our competitors, market size, market share, marketing strategy, SWOT analysis, and at the end with a conclusion.
Introduction.
So, starting with the introduction, the founder of OLX is Fabrice Grinda and Alec Oxenford. It was founded in 2006, and the current CEO of OLX India is Amarjit Singh Batra. It was being launched in 2009 in India, and its headquarters are in New York, United States. It's a C2C platform, which is a consumer-to-consumer platform.
What is OLX? It's nothing but consumer to consumer based company. It's a brand which connects directly without any mediocre, without any middleman, without paying any commission. You can actually direct sell product to the consumer. If suppose I want to sell this chair or I want to sell that table, I'll just post an ad from the application. Suppose he is the buyer or you all may be the buyer. So what exactly need to do is just I'll post an ad which can be featured one and free classified ads which you all will seeing in the OLX app, which directly connects you and me. This Ajitesh and me can be directly connected and we can actually chat, so that you can, as shown in figure, chat option is available. You can set location, you can browse the categories from the application, and some of the features which include that you can actually highlight the ad at the top, you can boost the ad at the top, you can, many more features are available. So free and easy posting of ad is available. You can post an ad for 7 days, 30 days and you can pay for it.
So starting with the types of ads, there are two types of ads in which the OLX is categorized, the free ad and the featured ad. In case of free ad, the ad is free of cost and we can post it without any fee. And for the featured one, the cost is being charged, and the basic difference between the free ad and the featured ad is that in case of free ad, our ad is not been displayed at top, but at the featured one, our ad has been displayed at top and is being shown frequently, so that the buyer is being aware of it and the mode becomes easier and faster. Here is a screenshot of feature ad being taken, describing the different sort of feature ad packages. Like for a 30 days, if we have to consider for a category like mobile, for a 30 days package, it costs rupees 299, and for a 7 days, it costs rupees 149. Similarly for the bike, it costs rupees 799 for a month and rupees 399 for 7 days.
So talking about the revenue growth and profit, in fiscal year 2017, the revenue recorded was 92 crore, which went up to 84% of growth, which became 170 crore in 2018. Now talking about the profit, in fiscal year 2017, it was around 8 crore. It went up to 95% and became 15 crore as shown. Competitors, do you?
So can anyone please suggest me who is the biggest competitor of OLX till now? Exactly. Yeah. So along with the Quikr, the competitors like Waiver Street, Click India, Two Good Services, EasySeller.com. And if we have to consider category wise, OLX considers from pets to the real estate. So categories like real estate, cars and mobiles, these are the category wise companies which have been the competitors of OLX.
For example, MagicBricks.com, 99acres.com, cars24.com and drone.in, gadi.in can be considered as category wise competitors. As example for furniture, bike and for jobs and services, we include shine.com, Zigwheels for bike and cars, and also bikedeco.com can be included in different competitors category wise. So talking about the market size, if we sum up the competitors total, so we get as 416 crore in fiscal year 2018. So Viva Street, India Street, Click India, OLX and Quikr, if we sum up total revenue of all this, we can get total market size.
So considering the market share of fiscal year 2018, the leading brand Quikr holds a share of around 44%, and after that OLX of around 40%, Click India of around 12%, and the Waiver Street of around 3%.
So talking about the marketing strategy, which include 4 P's: product, price, place and promotion. For product, it can be car, it can be in any category, it can be bike, it can be furniture or any category as already explained. Further featured ad and classified ad can be listed in product list.
So considering the price, as we have already referred, and we can consider there are three types of packages for the ad, like a super saver pack, light saver pack and a pro saver pack, which is a 10 ad, 3 ad and a 6 ad system. And if we have to consider a place for the OLX, then there are around 45 countries in which the OLX works, and in India there are around 1000 cities in which the OLX works.
So moving towards the promotion, so it was a first mover who the promotional lines which were applicable was OLX pe base de
ghar baithe kamao
OLX kar do. Yeah. Now talking about this word analysis, strength, weakness, opportunities and threats. Strength, which include it can be easy, simple, easily available, and it can be posted anytime. So it's a market leader of C2C and easily availability of products.
Now considering the weakness, if we have to consider the weakness, there can be a sort of frauds here, because it's whereas there is no authority here. So it's a direct platform between the customer and the customer, so there are been chances that the fraud chances occur. And there is no assurance of quality, because there are been many products in which we don't get the will. And for the villagers, like for those living in villages and who are not much exposed to internet, then it's sort of drawback for them. And suppose we have to buy a car, a particular brand of a car, but there are not all been filters of the car available. So this is somewhat a drawback or the weakness we can consider.
Opportunities: setting up offline stores for increasing its market size, it can be an opportunity for OLX. Also increasing demand of used goods. Yeah, used goods increases their demand. And talking about the threats.
So threats for the OLX: Big Bazaar, which provides discount on the old goods, it can act as a sort of drawback for them. And competitors like the rising new emerging companies, which provides new strategies and somewhat new methods, can act as sort of a drawback for OLX.
You all know what is the full form of OLX? Anyone? So moving towards the conclusion.
So OLX has attracted the, if we have to consider current scenario of OLX, it has attracted many new users till now. And for those who have not been able to afford to buy the products at the original price.
Thank you.
Thank you.